There we go. Okay, so I'm excited you guys are here. So my name's Kendall Boyd. I'm an Emerald. This is our typical team huddle night. And we love to just bring in guests because if you want to know what to do, follow those that are doing it, right? If you want to know how to have success, ask those that have had success. And so we love bringing in guests. We love just hearing from those that have had the struggles, but then have turned them into successes. And Morgan's name has popped up so many times on the Jewel page. You sweep every contest, you're on leaders boards. I mean, that's how I learned who you were. I'm like, who is this girl whose name just keeps coming up over and over and over? So I knew that we would all be blessed by just hearing her story. And then I asked her if she could share just some lessons she's learned along the way, maybe some tips that have helped her team. So we're excited to hear from you, friend. Take it away.
Awesome. Thank you, Kendall. Yes, I'm super excited to be here. And truthfully, I haven't told my story in a while. So going back through it kind of had me all in my feels. And so I do have notes so I don't get too squirrel and I am conscious of the time. And then Kendall, if you have questions or something specific, if I didn't clarify anything or whatever you want your team to have, thank you so much for having me. What an honor it is to be here. Truthfully, I was tricked into this business by the Lord. I started in 2016 secretly, skeptically, and didn't know why I needed the supplements. I felt like I was really healthy, felt like I was really balanced, knew nothing about gut health. I was not one of those people who was super health conscious and got into Plexus. I was like, maybe I took a Flintstone vitamin when I was a little kid. Maybe I didn't. I started taking vitamins when I started having babies. And, like, because I knew I needed a prenatal. So I was three kids in. If you guys know Krista Deary, she's one of my dear friends. She's my personal upline. And I watched her story unfold. So if you have not heard her testimony, it's like a crazy radical testimony where she got set free from lots of things. She was feeling at the lowest of lows. She was also at a low point in her finances. So how we got connected was through fundraisers she had for her special needs son, Judah. So I watched her come from a valley and then I watched Plexus change her life. So I knew that she was the real deal and that the supplements were the real deal. I just didn't know why I personally needed them. I was a pastor's wife. Now I don't call myself a pastor's wife because my husband is in ministry, but we don't pastor a church. So he travels, writes books, does all the things. So we're still in ministry, just not pastoring a church currently. We do support the church that Krista and Chad now pastor. So it's been a fun full circle moment. But at the time, I was pastoring a church in Lakeland, and we had seen MLM done the wrong way. We had seen network marketing done the wrong way. So we were a super opposed to network marketing. But I thought, okay, I want to be healthier. So, and I feel drawn to Krista. So I reached out to Krista and said, hey, I feel like I'm supposed to take these supplements. Please don't tell anyone. Let me know what I need. Here is kind of like how I am. I told her I was really balanced. I really liked healthy food, but I also really liked chocolate. And I was a tired mama of three, pretty active as I thought. And so she was like, well, everyone starts with the triplex and you can add X factor and that can replace your prenatal. Because I was a pastor's wife, she had talked me into joining wholesale. So I joined 7 years ago. So my language is different than it is currently. I will bring that full circle. But I joined wholesale and I had two other friends who were already looking to ask Krista to buy. And so I was connecting them to Krista and saying, hey, me and these two friends, my friend Julie, my friend Jess, they want to try these supplements too. So because I was the connector, she said, well, why don't you join wholesale and they can order from you and your products will be discounted. So no one outside of my husband, Julie, and Jess knew that I took the supplements and I was planning to keep it that way like forever. So the end of April 2016, I ordered my supplements, started taking them very consistently, did exactly what Krista told me. And I realized I wasn't taking naps with my kids anymore. I had energy that I didn't know that I needed. My milk supply went up, which was a fun fact. I was nursing a 6-month-old at the time. I had three kids, four and under. My sciatic pain went away. My migraines went away. I wasn't getting sick as often. What else happened? Chocolate cravings. Okay, people knew me by Morgan is addicted to chocolate. I told you I am in ministry, you know it by the potlucks and the dessert tables. Couldn't resist anything, would make cookies for my kids, tell them to have one, eat the whole plate myself. So I thought, well, you just don't have enough self-control. I didn't realize it was a gut health issue. So many things that I had accepted as normal, I realized, hey, these things really aren't as normal as you think. And maybe there are other moms out there that think that too. I still was way too prideful to share it. My own mom did not even know that I was taking the supplements. And I stayed secret until October 2016, the very last week of the month. Krista Deary was going for Emerald. She was blasting it all over a team page. I didn't even know what it meant. I didn't know what my order meant for her or Julie or Jess's. And she was saying she needed 10 more orders to go Emerald. And I was like, I feel like I'm supposed to help her. So I reached out, told my husband, I think I'm supposed to help Krista. I don't know what that looks like. Maybe we can order 10 times and help her get to Emerald. So I asked him and he was like, do whatever you want. So I reached out to Krista and I said, I think I'm supposed to help you get to Emerald. Can I be one of those 10 orders? She said, well, your order actually is already qualified, and explained that if I could get other friends like Julie and Jess to order, that would help her. So what I did is I sent out a mass text to like 10 friends. She had a belly buster challenge, which was just her version of a weight loss challenge. I said, hey, I got 10 extra pounds from after having Lydia. I'd like to lose them. Who wants to lose pounds with me? I think there were about 5 people who ordered from that. So I quickly went silver without posting once. But I realized, hey, I can do this. Like, I have a gift that other people need. And the more that I heard other people's stories, the more that I realized I'm keeping something from them. And so I started praying about it, and I felt like the Lord wanted me to do it. And I said, okay, Lord, if this is really you, I'll post once a day for a year and see where this goes. And if nothing else, I'm proving to you that I'm going to be obedient. I'm going to lay down my pride, like whatever you want to do. I'm here for it, but I'll post once a day for a year. See if people want this thing, see where it goes. Talk to my husband. He gave me the green light, which I knew had to be the Lord, because we were so resistant to network marketing just 6 months earlier. We were like, please don't tell anyone I'm ordering this from you. Please don't tell anyone we're in the business. And then he gave me the green light. Go for it. Post. Do whatever you want. So from then, I stayed consistent. So my first tip for you is commit. Go all in and stay consistent. Give yourself enough time to do something to see results. What I didn't know I was doing back then was committing, and committing to be consistent in daily activities. So for a year, I posted, but then the team also had a simple system for me to follow. So when I would post and somebody would comment or reach out to me with interest, I would add them to an info page that had tons of testimonies. When they would reach out to me, I would ask them what their health struggle was, or if I already knew them, I already knew maybe they were a tired mom. I already knew that they were struggling with XYZ. So I would search on that page, hey, they have thyroid issues, they need to lose weight. And I would find a testimony that would remind me of them, and I would tag them in that testimony, or I would send them the testimony and say, hey, this reminds me of you. Is this something that you would need? Then I would put them in a three-way with Krista. So me, Krista, and this person were all talking, but what that was doing was training me things I didn't know. So I knew nothing about the business. I knew nothing about natural health. Thank goodness Krista did. And she was able to help me. So through that year, I was getting training while also growing a business. And then by the end of that next year, towards the end of the year, I ended up having 2 miscarriages. So that kind of slowed me down a little bit. I needed to heal. I maintained my team. I did go senior gold by the end of that year, which at that time, big welcome packs didn't count. And actually, welcome packs didn't count at all. So I started very different. So if you are newer to this business, I'm telling you what, run as fast as you can. Because when we started, welcome packs didn't count as points. So you had to have people join, get a welcome pack, stay consistent. And now we're getting paid on welcome packs and for retaining them. Like, it's wild, the income opportunity that we have now versus 7 years ago. So don't take that for granted. So I'm going to continue to go through my timeline. So I joined April 2016, started taking the supplements in May, was secret until about November, started posting, stayed consistent for a year. Towards the end of that year, I did have a couple miscarriages and had to heal from that. But the supplements and the community were life-changing. Like, I was able to physically heal from having miscarriages way faster than if I wouldn't have had these supplements. And then the community that rallied behind us was absolutely incredible. God knew I would need the community and the support of the health supplements when I was going through that time. There's a whole testimony and all of that. But December 2017, I ended up being pregnant with my rainbow baby. I felt wind in my sails again. I was feeling good about the business, was still senior gold. And in June 2018, I was at 285 points. If you're not familiar with points, you'll just have to kind of track with me, but I will kind of give you a clue of, like, it's a big deal. So from June 2018 to July 2018, so 1 month, I was 285 points. And then in July, July 25th is my sweet Hadassah Faith's birthday. She was born on July 25th, and all of a sudden, I felt massive momentum. I think I could be incorrect, but I think 2018 is when the big welcome packs started counting as points. So my team grabbed a hold of that incentive and ran like crazy. So if you guys don't see something like an iPad, like a Nike's, custom Nike's incentive, when you see that Plexus is releasing incentives, grab a hold of that like it's your own business and let your team see what a massive impact that incentive can do for your team. So for my team, we were at 285. Probably when Hattie was born, we were probably close to 285. So in 5 days, we jumped at least 200 points. I'm positive we jumped at least 200 points. But I ended July 2018 at 510 points. So I nearly doubled my points from June 2018 to July 2018. So I had my rainbow baby, got the promise of momentum in my team, stayed there for a while. December in network marketing is not my favorite month. There are always exceptions to the rule, but typically people are busy with the holidays. So if you just had a poor December, that is not an indicator of anything. I can promise you that it is normal. People are spending their money on other things. They're eating sugar. They don't want to think about health. They're buying Christmas presents. But right now is the best time to start building momentum in your business. So then in 2019, I re-ranked and hit Ruby again. So I'd fallen down in December to February. And then in April, so March 2019, I was at 564 points. And I started to feel massive momentum once again hit my team. We went from 564 to 938 in 1 month. That was from March to April. I find that March and April in network marketing are months where it explodes, because typically in January and February, you're planting seeds and people are getting a good idea of they want to see health happen. And I really think that they're like, they run out the gate, like, give me good health supplements, get me in the gym, but they're not ready to fully commit until they see in March that they're not hitting the goals that they wanted to in January. So all of a sudden they're like, somebody help me. I need help alongside my resolutions because I'm not doing it on my own. And they're ready for us to come alongside them and really help them through. June 2019, I knew that the Lord wanted me to go emerald. I have a supernatural story where I found an emerald cut diamond. I can send you that testimony. It's a little bit long for this Zoom today, but I knew in my heart, like, I wasn't just supposed to hit senior Ruby, but we were going jewel and that the Lord was going to take us all the way. But in March 2020, I had hit my lowest points that I had in a long time. We were at 873, and I was like, Lord, how is emerald going to happen? So here's another tip for you guys. There are always ebbs and flows of your business. You guys have heard there are valley seasons, there are mountaintop seasons. Oftentimes, we go through the hardest things. We have the biggest setbacks right before your biggest breakthrough. So there is going to be testings and trials of like, are you really supposed to be here? So we have to be rooted in a foundation of this is where you're supposed to be. You do believe that you can do this and know that there will be hardships, but you can overcome any of them. I heard very clearly in April of 2020 to invite people into my journey and let them know it was possible. We were sitting around 900 points. I started to feel wind in my sails again. I knew that there were a couple times the year previously where I thought we were going to go emerald. We were 60 orders away 2 months in a row, and I didn't want to disappoint my team again. So I prayed as a leader and I was like, Lord, what am I supposed to do? And he said, invite people into your journey and let them know what's possible. There are so many possibilities for our businesses, y'all, but we have to partner with them. The partnership is so important. We can believe all day, but if we're not doing anything about it, then we're going to sit exactly where we are, right? The saying, nothing changes if nothing changes, is so true. So I have maintained Emerald the entire time. I've never lost rank of Emerald. I went Sapphire in August 2020, and I'm maintaining there. I do fluctuate between Emerald and Sapphire, and I have remained Sapphire for a few months now, and we are headed towards Diamond. So I'm super, super excited about that. I wanted to just give you a few more of my tips from my personal journey. And really, when I look back at my journey, I wish I would have known this stuff at the beginning, but I look back to like, where did my success come from? Well, it came from being my own runner for a long time. Y'all, I had one person in the course of that timeline go Emerald, and she fell back from there. Most of my points are gold points and below. So I have a lot of golds, a lot of silvers. I'm a very wide team, and I build very relationally. The beautiful thing about Plexus is that it can look differently. Like every business can be different. There can be three rubies on your team and you're an emerald, but you also can have a whole lot of silvers or a whole lot of golds, or maybe you have one rock star emerald and you have just a couple little outside legs. It does not matter what your business looks like. Just lean into building relationship and trusting the Lord. Working like it depends on you, but praying like it depends on God. All right. So be your own rock star. Be the runner that you want before somebody joins you. You have to be willing to do what you're telling other people to do. In the beginning of my journey, the best thing that I did was I didn't know what I was doing. So I was just doing things and inviting people to do it with me. So I'm like, I posted. Y'all should post too. I was giving them examples of posts. I was showing them how to add people to the info page. After I was doing three ways with Krista, then I was taking that to my downline and being like, hey, if you have friends and family members that are interested, throw them in a three way with me. Because when people are like me and they're clueless about the business or even natural supplements, they need some information. They need some help. And they're like, how am I going to build a business if I don't really know about the business or if I don't really know about the supplement? So if you've been in this for a while and you're inviting your team to do it too, show them how easy it can be. Show them that you can do it in the car. It's okay if your kids are in the background. They can see that anybody can do this. Number two is that I think you should go to events and you should have your own events. The amount of people that want community is crazy. We just had Super Saturday. So whether you could have went to Phoenix or you had your own, gather people together and simply let them try the pink drink. Sometimes it's just overcoming that it's not going to be gross. People have this idea in their head that natural supplements are really nasty. And once they taste the pink drink, the active, the hydrate, they're like, this is good. I could drink this every day. And they're ready to go all in. But also, I accidentally earned a leader's retreat my first year. I didn't even know it was an earned trip, and it was in Orlando. At the time, I lived in Lakeland, Florida, and so it was only 30 minutes away. I drove over to Leaders Retreat, where Krista informed me that not everybody could go to Leaders Retreat, and I was amazed. Like, I could not believe what Plexus offered. And then it opened my eyes to so many other people that did this business. And I would say the top two events, so convention was in Orlando and leaders retreat that I accidentally earned. So my first event was a leaders retreat. And then the second one was that convention that was in Orlando. And I saw their lanyards and it was like, wow, like old people are jewels. Big people are jewels. Little people are jewels. Every type of person is a jewel. Where in my head, jewels were only people who did YouTube trainings. Like I did not realize that there were so many jewels and that anybody, every shape, size, color, and age over 18 could get to a jewel status. So my mind was like, oh, maybe anybody really can do this and it's not just for a select few. So if you aren't planning on going to convention, I highly encourage you to go to convention. It will change your mind. Or your blow your mind, but it will change your perspective. I have a girl on here tonight, Jessie. She went to convention with us and it changed her whole perspective. And she realized this business is the real deal. So she was a happy customer. She was kind of in and out, but when she went to convention, she went all in. So go to convention, get your people to convention. It makes them realize that there's something really there. I remember a mindset shift, the first 1099, I think that's what we get, that I got that said $60,000. My husband looked at me and said, you have to stop telling people that you have a side hobby, that you kind of do Plexus. Like you make more than some of your friends. And I'm like, okay, but that just seems weird. Like I resisted that I had a business for so long. But as soon as I shifted into that gear, business results showed up. My paycheck doubled. Like the possibilities with Plexus are truly amazing. Third tip is follow up, follow up, follow up, follow up, and follow up again. I follow up all the time. Well, Morgan, I don't want to be bothersome. I don't want people to think I'm annoying. I didn't either. And what I realized was one, if people thought that I was annoying, that was more on them than it was on me. So it really has to do with your heart. What is your heart for that person? And that's all that you are in charge of, and make it as relational as possible. So I typically reach out to somebody. At this point, I'm reaching out to people who have shown me interest. When somebody shows me that they have interest, I'm going to follow up with them until they order and or until they tell me no. So those are the two things. Once they tell me no, they're not off my list, but I do stop following up and I respect their no, but I'm going to continue to build relationship because some of those no's have turned to yeses when they need the supplements or when they need the business. So you have to keep relationship with all of those people and it shows that your heart motives are pure and they weren't just for the sale. So make sure you do care about that person. And if you do care about that person, they hear that in your voice. So I follow up all the time. The main time I follow up over and over and over again is when there's a new sale or a new product. So I reach out to people and I'm just like, hey, I know that you, the last time we talked, it probably wasn't the right time for you to join Plexus, but I thought of you because this is the sale that they're currently running. And I think it would be a great time for you to start. Is now the right time? Okay. They might ghost that and I might send five messages before they answer, but I can tell you, I probably have 200 customers who have ended up saying yes, even after they've ignored me five times. I personally miss messages all the time, or I think I respond in my head. How many of you guys are like, whoops, totally responded to that in my head. Like that's me all the time. So I'll just throw that out there. I'll be like, hey, I miss messages it here in here all the time. I'm not sure if you saw what I said before, but I had to circle back around because right now you can join and get a free bag of Slim. Are you ready to get started? So it's very simple and I'm just offering them typically what Plexus is offering them. If you're going for a rank up, you can individualize incentives for people. Hey, I'm picking five people this month to earn a free frother. You are one of those people I chose. Is now the right time for you? So there are so many different ways that you can follow up. But the more we make it about the other person, the more they feel that love. Hey, I just saw that you were sick through the holidays. These supplements have really helped me stay healthy. Are you ready to get started? So there are a couple ways that I do follow up with people, but the less weird we make it, the better. Just relate to the person and don't get upset if they say no. There are so many times that waitresses come up to me, they offer me desserts, they offer me drinks, they offer me all the things. Most of the time I say no. Like, hey, I am a water drinker at restaurants. Every time, what's the waitress say the first time? They're offering you all the upsell drinks, right? I'm like, no thanks, I'll take water. That waitress doesn't go in the back and cry. She's okay with that. So get used to people saying no, not right now. That is not a reflection of you, and continue to follow up. One major shift that we've made on our team is we're a huge proponent of watching trainings, and I do think you should watch a training a day, but if you're not applying anything, don't watch another one until you've applied something. So don't just watch trainings, but make sure you're applying it and making it work for your business. Don't get stressed out with every video that you watch. I guarantee you that I don't run my business like Kendall, and that's okay because our lives are not the same, right? I don't run my business like Jesse, or I could keep going. So watch a training and make it apply to your life and your business, but watch out for excuses. Are you saying I can't do that because you're afraid? You will not overcome obstacles in your business if you're watching trainings and being like, I could never do that. Grab a hold, take out all the golden nuggets, go through your fears, pray, process, and figure out how you can apply that to your life, to your business, and make it work. So watch trainings and apply them to your business and your lifestyle, and you're going to start to watch the needle move. Before you start to do anything, though, promise me that you will build your business on a firm foundation. The foundation is built on belief. You have to have belief in yourself that you can do this. So I'm looking at all the faces that are on this Zoom, and I'm saying each of you can do this business. Whatever your goal is, if you want to go senior gold, I believe you can do that. Set that goal for yourself. See where you need to push through into what you need to do to be successful. Figure out what lies are you telling yourself. Are you saying, well, I'm not like so-and-so. I'm not an influencer. I don't have 100-something followers on Facebook. It's so easy for some of us to look at Trisha Regger and see her success and say, man, she has hundreds of thousands of followers on Instagram. Of course she's successful. Well, she didn't start that way. Actually, Trisha Regger started from nothing and built a social media business. Is that trajectory the one that you want, or are we just sitting in comparison? Comparison will steal your joy all day, or you can look at your circumstance and say, how am I going to become successful? And figure out the tools that you need to become successful. So what are your goals? Set up a plan in order to fulfill what your goals are. Without vision, people perish. You have to have a vision for yourself and for your business, but you have to start with believing that you can do this, right? You can hear my story all day and be like, well, of course Morgan got to Sapphire and this is why she's there. I know that because I was there, y'all. I had said at the beginning, oh, I'm not doing this business to become a jewel. I'll never become a jewel. Well, once I got the vision for it and I believed that I could, I was unstoppable. I was going to do this thing until I become a diamond because I know that I'm supposed to be a diamond. So I have belief that I'm going to be a diamond. I have belief in the supplements and I have belief in the business. So first you have to start with belief in yourself. Do you believe that you can do this? Because you 100% can. I've seen everyone and anyone do it. I've seen people who have large networks do it, and I've seen people who have small ones. So it does not matter. It doesn't matter if you're a woman or a man, you can do this. So make sure you have belief. If you don't, start there. Talk to your leaders. Figure out, why can you do this? How can you do this? Find a diamond documentary of somebody who is in your exact position and stand on the belief that you can achieve this. And then, of course, you need belief in the supplements and belief in the business. Most of us have belief in one of those three areas. When you have belief in all three of those areas, you're going to be unstoppable. I'm 100% sure of that. Trust the process. If I would have told myself, like, hey, listen, in 4 years, you're going to be emerald. Everybody would spend 4 years to make a six-figure income to go to Hawaii every year to have a Lexus. Like, that's a no-brainer and a crazy rate of raises. I would have said that if you told me 10 years. If it takes me 10 years to diamond, I'm here for it, because that's an extreme pay raise, right? So make sure you're believing there. Final thing that I will land with is, what is my team currently doing, or what analogies do we hold on to? So we like to use two analogies. I'll give you both of them because not everybody is a runner. My favorite analogy is a 90-day cycle of walking, running, sprinting. Okay. So for 30 days, we're going to walk. Right now in January, we're in a walking season. What does that look like for us? We're getting our systems in place. I'm talking to my leaders about what can we do to better our businesses? How can we step it up a notch? I'm staying consistent in posting reach outs, follow-ups, and trainings. That's a non-negotiable for me. I'm going to do income producing activity every single day forever, except my Sabbath day. Like, that is a non-negotiable. And then when I'm walking, I'm making sure I'm setting up my systems, okay? Then we're going to start to run. So everything is set in place. My leaders are on board. Now we're going to start to pick up the pace a little bit. So I might amp up my posts. I'm going to amp up my reach outs, amp up my follow-ups, continue with training and applying. And then the finish 90 days is sprinting. So it's like, okay, now we've set up the systems, we've picked up the pace a little bit, and we're in a rhythm to really run, and we go all in. So ideally, especially in littler ranks, I'm setting people up to go gold by that 90th day. Okay. I'm setting people up to go senior gold by that 90th day. I'm setting myself up to have bigger rank ups there. Same thing with a garden, okay? You can't plant seeds and expect there to be a flower the next day. So the first 30 days, you might be doing a ton of reach outs. You might be setting yourself up there, plant seeds, plant seeds, plant seeds. And then you're going to tend the garden. You have to build relationship. You have to put water on all those seeds that you just planted. You have to continue to build belief in the business and the supplements in your network that you've started to scatter the seeds at. And then, of course, the last 90 days, you're reaping the harvest. It's a sowing and a reaping concept. So whether you want to run it out or you want to plant some flowers, you're going to see success if you do the main things. Set yourself up some easy systems. Commit to your team, commit to your business, and then take it up a notch. And then you have to go right back to step one, because if you always sprint, you're going to burn out. Like, if you've ever been a runner, you can't sprint forever. You have to start walking again, and then you get yourself back up, and then you sprint again, and then you have to walk again. This is going to prevent burnout. It's going to get you into a healthy rhythm so you can have long-term success, so your family doesn't burn out, so your marriage is intact, so you can set yourself and those around you up for success. So that's kind of what I have for you tonight. Kendall, do you have any questions? Are we gonna open it up for questions?
Yes, so both.
Yes, so both.
And I had so many good nuggets. I mean, there's so much good stuff here. And I just love, some of the best lessons we learn are from looking back from our own journey, right? I mean, we all probably started as skeptics. We all probably thought we'd never get our first customer. We all probably thought the family member would never jump in. No one would ever share. Like, yet it's when you trust the process and you don't, cave to that fear and cave to the doubt. Like, that's faith, right? And so if you believe you're here with a purpose, have faith in that. So much good stuff. One thing you said that I did want to ask about, so you talked about how important it is to build a wide team and have multiple leader legs. And, you know, that's something I know Jim Viev talks about a lot, building wide. And that is a unique thing about our company, that if you've never looked at other compensation plans from other network marketing companies, a lot of them don't necessarily allow you to build wide, unlimited. Usually it's kind of limited to just a few legs. And so I do love to just kind of hear other teams, if there are specific onboarding things you do with your level ones, systems that you follow with your own level ones that one, give them success on the products, because we all love to retain our customers that we've worked so hard to follow up with for years. But also duplication is such an important part of this. And it's something I know my team, we're all working on focusing more on having that conversation of sharing. And I love that your story, it was from her just sharing that she had a goal. Like even sharing our goals with our customer, people want to help people. And so there's so many ways to do that. But I just wanted to see, you know, just kind of your onboarding systems with that stuff in mind.
Yeah, that's great. Well, and I feel like even multifaceted. So very early on, I read the Color Personality book. It's a very short book. I did not read, and I'm becoming a better reader. Readers are leaders, and I fully believe that. But it's never been an easy thing for me. And so I read that four color personality thing. But here's the thing. So if you haven't read it, I'll just summarize it. There are, all of us have different motives, right? And so there are going to be people who come in for the fun. They come in for like the party, right? So convention, the gala, it's super appealing to them. Your team event, super appealing to them. Okay. There's going to be people that would be blue, red. They're coming in for the money, the success. They care about onstage recognition. They care about the big checks. They want to be a leader. There are yellow personalities that want to help people. They're very kind and conflict is very hard for them, but they're all about helping. Okay. So there are people who want to help you. These are the people that when you say, I need six people to help me reach this goal by the end of the month, will you be one or whatever, those, you know, those magic posts, they're going to reach out to those. The words, I need help, spark a yellow personality. So that was me, like somebody who was like, I need 10 people. I'm like, yeah, girl, I'll help you, whatever you need. So those are the yellows. And then I'm missing one, yellow, red, oh, green. They care about the information, right? Is that you? So they want to know that the supplements work, right? They're coming in to be like, okay, these supplements work. They're more of the information-based people. So I try to promote to all of them. And I live my life out loud on Instagram and Facebook. So my team is relationally through Facebook. We still do Facebook groups. And then Messenger. We use Messenger like crazy. So I have a personal Morgan's 1-3 thread that everything goes there. When I watch a good training, I put a training in there. I used to put a training every day, but I'm trying to equip my team to find their own trainings as well and post them in there. So it's a community. It's not just Morgan gets to talk to all of these people. I want them to feel like they have buy-in. And when other people feel like they have leadership, you're helping other people rise when you step out of the way too. And so our Messenger threads are huge. We're now trying Trisha Rager's 90-day consistency accountability threads. So those seem to be going really well too. So those are for new customers. I feel like I haven't done it long enough to be like, yes, these are working for my team. But we are doing that currently. Previous to that, though, we just onboarded them to our Facebook group and to our community. And then we're super relational. And so when they join, our team is called Team Revive. They feel like they're a part of something, like you just joined something and we're way more concerned about the impact it has on your life and your family's life and your community's life than we are about a quick sale. And so people want that. I believe that the supplements change people's lives. And so my first event was Krista's Emerald Celebration, where I met the people that were on the info page and all their testimonies. And I was like, oh, these are real people. Like, she really is off 7 medications and she really is making lots of money. And so it wasn't just a testimony on a screen anymore. These were real people telling me their testimonies in person. And so that was life-changing. So I feel like getting people, like not just the triplex, but you're showing them all of these people have had success. And the truth is, guys, like people are suffering with things that they'll never tell you. So if they're on an info page or you're sharing other people's testimonies, they're like, oh, I joined this to lose weight, but actually I've been suffering with eczema for years, or I actually kind of have anxiety and depression that I've never told anybody about. But when they see a testimony, it spurs them on to continue on. Or they reach out and they're like, hey, actually, I'm struggling with this and I didn't tell you that. Are these supplements good or what should I be taking? And it allows them to continue to open up. more and more and more. Like, we are in the people's business, and the more that we can care about them and get them on the right supplements, they'll be lifers. I have people who have been ordering for 7 years. Like, they have stuck around for 7 years. And I didn't understand our comp plan at all until probably like I went Emerald, honestly, and I realized I needed to teach other people that. That's how simple it is, y'all. It is very simple. When people talk about other comp plans and how you have to have two legs and you have to spread them out, I don't even understand that. I'm trying to understand that more now that people are coming in for the business and they're confused, or they'll ask me questions and I'm like, oh no, like that's not a thing. I've never, ever had to worry about my outside legs, never. And the reason being is I just have added so many people. And so I think a wide business is the way to go all day. Is it easier when you're building down? 100%. So I love that we're focusing on golds, because if you can have a lot of really healthy gold teams, you're going to be a jewel for sure.
Yeah, I love that. I mean, it's just one of those things. There's so many different ways to inspire people. It's just trying all the things. Right. It's trying something. And then if it doesn't work exactly how you want, not letting that mean that you can't do it. Right. Try another thing. And I love that you talked about trainings daily, plug into things, but then take one nugget to apply and see what happens. So I love that. I do want to give, if anybody else has a question that they want to ask Morgan, I do want to give y'all a chance to be able to ask that. So if anyone has a question.
I'll ask a question. What podcasts or books or whatever do you most recommend?
That's a good one. So I loved Valerie Burton, like loved Valerie Burton. I'm a huge Bob Heilig fan. So those would probably be my top two. John Maxwell, I love him. Oh, and if you have not seen, Eric Worre's Recruit 20 People in 30 Days or something like that. He goes gangbusters. You have to watch it with, but I firmly believe that if you give yourself, so I would attribute that to like the sprinting. So if you watch that video, he gives you tools on how to be massively successful to be a six-figure income in network marketing. So that YouTube kind of set me on fire to get momentum going on my team again. Cause when you hit jewel level, you shift in, like, you're not ranking up. You have to become a leader of leaders and help raise them up. So that YouTube was extremely helpful to help business builders. And y'all need to be promoting the business online. Do not shy away from the business. I don't care if you're silver. Like, there are people who want $200, $300. And so use your own testimony, because it's way more relatable to say, hey, I just got, Marielle, are you really on here? Will you type that YouTube Eric Worre's video? Are you really on here? Like, are you listening? Can you type? You might be in the car. There she is. What was I saying? Something. Oh, promote the business. So like, most of the time I myself could not see myself as a jewel. Most people are like, hey, I just need some grocery money. So that's super powerful. Use your own testimony. And then of course use Kendall's testimony, use our testimonies, and show that we're in Hawaii or in Mexico, because those are belief builders. But it's also way more relatable to just be like when I went Ruby, I went to the nail salon and got my nails done Ruby with my girls, and that was awesome. And I posted it and told everybody, hey, this was our Ruby achievement. But to answer your question, Kelly, top people would be Valerie Burton, Bob Heilig, John Maxwell. You cannot go wrong with John Maxwell. And I think he's wildly successful. And if we just continue to do those things, it's super, super helpful.
Yeah. And there's podcasts for all of them. And I love that it's just so easy to access podcasts. That's what I do every morning, just a 20-minute podcast of some kind. And it just sets your mindset for the day, and that determines your actions. So I love it. Does anybody else have a question that they want to ask? Oh, and I see the YouTube dropped in the chat. Thank you so much, guys, for that. I see two different links though, so I don't know which one is the right one. But I think it's his GoPro. I think it's the Air Quarry GoPro. His book GoPro is about that as well. But even if you just go to Google and type in Air Quarry, 20 and 30 YouTube video, like they're gonna have it. It's gonna pull it up. It's very, very popular and very effective. So, anybody else have any questions?
Well, I just want to say thank you. Kendall, kind of my biggest takeaway was, we listened to a training, but before you move on to the next thing, right? Information is useless without implementation. So I really love just the reminder of just getting back to listen to something, find out what your takeaway is, and before you move on to the next thing, implement it, right? Like write it down, really analyze it and implement it. So that's just such a good reminder that you can only consume so much information where it's just information overload. It's implementation that really is the game changer.
And that applies to this call tonight. What is one thing Morgan said that really kind of connected with you and made you think, ah, that's the thing I need to be working on, or that's the thing I need to try, or the thing I need to listen to, even tonight? It's just always such a good reminder. Apply, apply, apply. So, Morgan, we're just so thankful for you, girl. I really appreciate you giving us time and your team joining us. I love when we all get to just pull teams together and learn together and just be encouraged together. So, thank you all for being here. And I see in the comments the walk, run, sprint. I loved that concept too, of just not always feeling like you have to sprint. We can't always sprint, yet we always feel the pressure too. It's like, I gotta show up. I gotta show up. There's an incentive. There's a goal, right? But I love that you're just so systematic with it, because that brings longevity in this, and that brings peace and rest and joy and all of, and you have wins, more wins than burning yourself out because you've pushed too hard. So I love all of that. Well, thank you guys. Oh, Did you want to say?
I guess before we go, yeah, that the looking at your business like as in a 90-day cycle, do you have that written out anywhere? Do you have IPAs that correlate with where you are with a walk, run, sprint, or anything like that?
I did a brief thing on the Jewel page, but I think I'm about to do a video because I talked about it in, I think it was Mexico or somewhere, and so I'll put it together and I'll get it to Kindle.
That'd be awesome. Thank you so much.
Perfect. Well, thank you guys. We appreciate you all.